looks good.
My name is Sam Kasing. I'm with San Diego State University. I'm a professor in mechanical engineering department, specifically with the bioengineering program. I am one of the PIs in this engineering research center, which is known as Center for Sensorimotor Neural Engineering. We went through a five-year review last May of this year, and we're pleased to learn that our grant has been approved for the next 5 years, which is 2016 to 2021. The money is from 15 to 20 million, and we will be able to continue our work and actually produce major milestones building upon the success that we had in the past 5 years.
This was actually my dream job. When I came here and had the opportunity to work on medical devices for the brain, it was extremely excited because it's exactly what I want to do, and it's the brain. I mean, who isn't interested in the brain?
Believe it or not, in the United States alone, we have about 100,000 people with electrodes implanted in their brains, which actually allow them to lead normal lives, particularly patients of Parkinson's disease or chronic depression or anybody with spinal cord injury. The electrodes that we're working on in my lab at San Diego State University are made of carbon. And we think over a long term, it has corrosion resistance much better than metals. And through collaboration with our partners at University of Washington and MIT, we're learning how the brain is responding to our electrodes. At this point, we have developed enough data sets to convince us that the electrodes that we manufacture in our lab are robust enough for a long-term implantation, particularly where electrical stimulation of the electrodes is involved.
This particular design is meant for electrochemical detection, and this design is meant for electrical stimulation.
When you stimulate the brain, many unknown phenomena happen. For example, the acidity and basic nature of the fluid surrounding the brain actually changes. That interface where silicon or carbon hits your tissue is an interesting area, and that has been a very challenging area to overcome and to understand. But that will eventually determine the success of the mission of our center. And we hope over the next 5 years, we'll understand more of this and make the brain-computer interface more natural.